Hey YouTube, Jim here. Welcome to Top 10 Archive. Thanks to doctors, scientists, and researchers of years gone by, we now have powerful medicines and intelligent inventions that save lives, make tasks easier, and generally improve our quality of life. But every now and again, experiments are done that are so crazy that it's hard to believe they actually happened, which is what brings us to the Top 10 Craziest Science Experiments Ever Conducted. But before we get started, why not become an archivist today by clicking that subscribe button and notification bell so you don't miss out on any future uploads. If you end up enjoying this video, let us know by giving it a thumbs up, and in the comments section, tell us which experiment freaked you out the most. Number 10, two-headed dog. You may remember this experiment from our Top 10 Scary Pictures with Creepy Backstories video, but it's just too bizarre not to mention again in this video. An American physiologist named Charles Claude Guthrie was renowned for his work with vascular surgery, and work that he collaborated on with French physician Alexis Carrel actually won the Nobel Prize in Physiology for Medicine in 1912. But Guthrie was denied the prize even though he clearly contributed to the work. Why, you ask? Well, it was probably because he loved to do head transplant experiments with dogs. Yes, that's right. This American psycho loved to sew the head of one dog onto another. Incredibly, he did actually have success with keeping some of his patients alive. Guthrie sadly wasn't the only person to experiment with doggos. Russian Vladimir Demikhov was also renowned for it. His wild approach to medicine did lead to the birth of successful heart transplants, which has saved the lives of millions of people. But his approach to creating two-headed dogs to get to that point doesn't sit well with a lot of people. Number 9. MK Ultra. Otherwise known as the CIA Mind Control Program, Project MK Ultra was a sometimes illegal program of experiments on humans. These experiments were designed to identify and develop drugs and procedures to be used in interrogations with the aim of weakening people and forcing confessions through mind control. MK Ultra used unwitting US and Canadian citizens as its test subjects, and methods of manipulation included the administering of LSD and other drugs, hypnosis, isolation, and even abuse and torture. This was a huge experiment, and tests were said to have taken place at 80 institutions that included colleges, hospitals, and prisons. These crazy experiments were sanctioned in 1953, and it's thought that they were halted in 1973 when the CIA director at the time ordered all MKUltra files to be destroyed. Although there remains controversy over whether the experiments are actually secretly still going on today. Number 8. The Homunculus. Paracelsus was a renowned 16th century physician and alchemist known for his work in psychotherapy and toxicology. He also led the way in the conversation about our unconscious mind and was undoubtedly a genius. But some of his experiments were odd, to say the least. His weirdest work was probably his homunculus, which is basically a tiny human that is apparently created when a human egg is transplanted into the womb of a horse and fed human blood. I'll give you a second for that to sink in. Can you believe that there's no proof of this out there experiment ever working? Nah, me neither. Number 7. Prison skin experiments. Dr. Albert M. Kligman is credited with perhaps the most disturbing quote in history. "All I saw before me were acres of skin. It was like a farmer seeing a field for the first time." Even without context, that's creepy. But it gets crazier once you know what he's talking about. Dr. Kligman is the man behind Retin A, one of the most important ingredients for acne treatments and anti-wrinkle creams. But the way Kligman made his discovery was by testing his lotions and potions on incarcerated men in Holmesburg Prison, Philadelphia. It was the prisoner's skin that he was referring to in his horrifying quote, and for 2 decades, he subjected them to biopsies, procedures, and many, many formulas which had varying success.
The men tolerated the treatment, though, because they were given small cash prizes in exchange for burns, rashes, and infections. And we assume that they didn't have too many other options at the time. Number 6. Sleep deprivation. Remember the Russian sleep experiment story where an airborne stimulant kept 5 participants awake for 30 days? But after a few days of sleep deprivation, they lost their minds, mutilated themselves, and demonstrated superhuman strength? Well, that story turned out to be a creepypasta, or a complete hoax as it's otherwise known. But crazy sleep experiments do exist, and Randy Gardner's is one of the best known. Randy stayed awake for 11 days and 24 minutes during a scientifically observed experiment in 1964. Randy didn't attempt to practice self-cannibalism as the subjects of the Soviet hoax did, but he did show lower cognitive functioning and significant behavioral changes. He became paranoid, suffered from hallucinations, and struggled to concentrate on anything. Somehow, Randy managed to win a game of ping pong against one of the researchers on day 10, though, but I can only conclude that the researcher was terrible at ping pong. Number 5. Cat telephone. In 1929, two scientists named Ernest Glenn Weaver and Charles W. Bray decided to turn a cat into a telephone. The gruesome twosome began by extracting a piece of the cat's skull and placing an electrode on the animal's hearing nerves. This electrode was connected to an amplifier by a long cable, so when a sound went into the ear of the cat, it could be heard via the receiver in the other room. The experiment did work, and sound was transmitted clearly. This cruel and ridiculous experiment seemingly had no purpose, so what good does that information do? Well, although seemingly inhumane, their groundbreaking research helped to understand how sound is perceived by the auditory nerve. Without the foundation that they laid, we wouldn't have cochlear implants today. Number 4. Nikola Tesla's superweapon. Nikola Tesla is best known for his research in electricity and electromagnetism, but to others he was known as a bonkers scientist who was fascinated with superweapons. Specifically, he wanted to find a way to harness electricity to create a beam that was able to shoot down 10,000 enemy planes at a distance of up to 200 miles or 321 kilometers away. He also loved the idea of anti-gravity airships, time travel, and a thought photography machine which would allow people to take snapshots of their imagination. Tesla's experiments weren't the only weird thing about him either. He disliked anything round, was obsessed with pigeons, and hated fat people. As out there as Nikola Tesla seemed, his inventions and innovations changed the world forever, especially with alternating current, while some of his biggest breakthroughs never saw real-world applications. Number 3. Real-life Frankenstein. Frankenstein is one of the best-known horror stories of all time. But did you know that it's supposedly based on a real person? Johann Conrad Dippel was born in 1673 in Castle Frankenstein, and in that castle, he loved nothing more than to spend long days practicing alchemy and anatomy. He was rumored to have tried to move the soul of one dead person to another dead person's body, and it's said that he loved boiling up body parts, although I'm not entirely sure why. The mad scientist was credited with inventing Dippel's oil, a foul-smelling liquid made from distilled bones. This vile juice had a number of uses, including repelling insects and rendering wells undrinkable for enemies during World War II. Dippel was also accused of grave robbing, and although none of this is fully proven to have happened, he was eventually run out of town, so it's clear that the townspeople knew something was up. Number 2. Guatemala Syphilis Experiment. The Guatemala Syphilis Experiment sounds like a sequel to the hostile horror films, but this actually happened. Back in the 1940s, STDs were running rampant, but nobody really understood what they were or how they could be treated. Rather than infect their fellow US citizens, a group of medical professionals from Johns Hopkins University made the incredibly unethical decision to travel to Guatemala and infect unsuspecting residents of the Central American country. For at least 2 years, a team infected soldiers, sex workers, patients of mental health facilities, and anyone else that was deemed low class enough to be expendable. These poor folks ended up with gonorrhea, syphilis, and a whole host of other STDs so doctors could see how the infections presented and spread. Around 5,500 Guatemalans were involved in the research directly or by proxy, and only around 700 of these people ever received treatment. What's worse is that a minimum of 83 subjects were dead just 5 years after the experiment is said to have ended. Number 1. Nazi Experiments. The atrocities committed by the Nazis in the 20th century will haunt us for all eternity, but one of the worst villains was, no doubt, Dr. Josef Mengele. Auschwitz was hideous beyond words, and it was in this hellish place that Mengele liked to do his experiments. The monster was fascinated by identical twins, and he used them in unbelievably cruel tests. Among other unspeakable things, he would inject one twin with a mysterious substance and monitor them for illness. And if one twin died, he would kill the other and perform comparison autopsies on them both. He also liked to induce gangrene, inject dye into their eyes, and do spinal taps in an apparent effort to better understand twin genetics. Mengele was captured after the war, but released by mistake, and he eventually fled to Argentina. He was never recaptured and eventually died in a Brazilian holiday resort, having never been punished for his heinous crimes. Thanks for watching. Did you find this video interesting? Then be sure to give it a like and leave your thoughts about it in the comments section below. Remember to subscribe and click the bell before you go on to view another one of these videos.